exactly are those ancillary associated acts which you've spoken about, which inshallah you're going to furnish us with all the information, aside from doing away with food, drink and sexual relations with one's wife during the daylight hours of Ramadan, which will enable you to achieve the real objectives of fasting?
In short, if you want the answer in one sentence, it is obeying the commandments of Allah and His Messenger. If you obey the commandment of Allah and His Rasul, all His commandments, then inshallah, you'll be following all the necessary things. In detail, there are hundreds. We listed the major ones just a couple of days back when we discussed the topic recommended and discouraged acts while fasting. And if you remember, we had discussed 32 points in the topic of recommended acts while fasting and about 29 points in acts which are discouraged while fasting. Both put together 61. And in all these days, we have discussed more than 60 points which are recommended and discouraged. In short, if you follow the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger, you are doing the associated things. In short, to mention, just to highlight a few more, a few which we have discussed earlier, our beloved Prophet Muhammad said, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 3, in the book of fasting, hadith number 1901, our Prophet said that anyone who fasts the complete month for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for him, and seeking reward from him, he will have all his sins forgiven. So first thing is intention, it should be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we should do it to seek the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Furthermore, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 3, in the book of fasting, hadith number 1894, our Prophet said, fasting is a shield. And the message is repeated in same Sahih Bukhari, volume 3, book of fasting, hadith number 1904, where our Prophet said, fasting is a shield. It will protect you from the hellfire and prevent you from sins. And our Prophet said, it's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 3, in the book of fasting, hadith number 1903, he said, that anyone who does not leave his false actions and false speech, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not require him to leave his food and drink. Here, in this hadith, the major activities which are associated are mentioned in this hadith. It comes in two categories, false speech and false action. False speech, as we discussed earlier, includes backbiting, slandering, lying, verbal abuse, vulgar speech, gossiping, rumor mongering. In false action, we have things which people do very often in Ramadan, is listen to un-Islamic songs, listen to music, watch un-Islamic television programs, un-Islamic movies, read un-Islamic magazines, they go to un-Islamic websites, wastage, extravagance, all these come in this activity. And as I mentioned earlier, in the early answer, our beloved Prophet said in Sunan Ibn Majah, hadith number 1690, that there are many people who fast but they don't get any reward except hunger. And many people who stand in salah, their standing is useless, they get no reward except for sleeplessness. And our beloved Prophet also said in Sunan Ibn Majah, hadith number 4250, that anyone who asks for forgiveness for the sin he has done, it is as though he has not committed that sin. So in this month of Ramadan, you can ask for forgiveness, and inshallah, Allah will forgive your sins. And it's mentioned in Musnad Ahmad, hadith number 6626, that two things will act as intercession for you, fasting and the Quran. The fasting will say that this person left his desire of eating, drinking and sex for me, so I will intercede for him. And the Quran will say that this person, he kept on reading the Quran and I prevented him from sleeping, so I intercede on his behalf. So Quran and fasting will intercede for you on the day of judgment and will inshallah take you to Jannah.